Family traditions are cherished. Just deviate, though, from the usual and be prepared for a fight with your family. There's one Cleveland tradition that inarguably transcends seasons and has lasted a century. It's the West Side Market. Although she doesn't have to sell us, Mary Lou Susco is here to number the reasons why this landmark is such a great tradition. Mary Lou is the co-author with Laura Taxel of Cleveland's West Side Market, 100 years and still cooking. Thanks for joining us today.
Oh, thanks for having me here.
So this book, I've been looking through it, and it has tasty, true tales about the building and about the vendors and the people who shop there. For many people, this really is a tradition to go to the West Side Market.
Absolutely. The market is full of tradition. Tradition plays out every day at the market. A lot of people that come to the market shop like their parents used to shop. They shop with the same vendors. Maybe they get the same kind of food. Whatever is important to their table, whether it's a holiday or a special celebration, the market is a place where a lot of people come together.
And let's focus on the holidays. What's different about the market during the holidays?
Well, there's a couple of things that are different about the holidays. One is a lot of people come to the market at the holidays and they bring in family and friends who are from out of town and they show off our market because our market is so worth showing off. The other thing that happens and that we found as we were researching this book and talking to a lot of people over the past 2 years is that you're looking for the types of foods that define your culture or your particular family celebration. So if you make nut roll, you're looking for blue poppy seed. And one of the only places, one of the few places to get blue poppy seed, not black poppy seed, because blue is sweeter, is at the West Side Market. Or maybe there's a specific cut of meat that you like to bring to the table, you know, something that's kind of an indulgence or decadent. That's where you go to the West Side Market because the butchers are still there to trim that for you. Or marzipan pigs, which are very central to a lot of German celebrations.
So speaking of black poppy seed and blue poppy seed, if I go to the West Side Market now and it's almost Christmas, will I turn black and blue because I'm trampled by the crowds?
No, you won't. There, a lot of people do show up at the market during the holidays, but you can get around that in a couple of ways. You can come early or you can come later in the day, but you can just come anytime during the day and really just enjoy being there with people from all around the city. Chances are you're going to be standing in line waiting for something or admiring something or kind of discovering what's in the cases. And you're going to be standing next to somebody who's one of your Cleveland neighbors. So people tend to meet other people during the holidays. They share recipes. They talk about each other's traditions. It's really a great way to get to know your Cleveland neighbor.
Over the holidays, operating hours.
Operating hours, you know, luckily this year the market hasn't changed their regular hours because holidays fall around the market hours. So it's open Monday and Wednesday, 7 until 4, and then Friday and Saturday from 7 until 6.
Very good. And is there a quick story you can share with us from
the
book?
Oh, there's a million quick stories.
It's got to be a quick one.
Okay, a quick one. Well, I think a lot of your readers are going to recognize a lot of references in the book to the Hildebrandt Meat Company. A lot of people, whether you as a kid or whether you worked in the steel mills, you're going to remember that a lot of your lunches included Hildebrandt sliced meats. And they had two stands at the market starting from the very beginning in 1912 up until 1971.
And the stories are in here and you can catch up and reminisce and have all kinds of good times.
It's a great reminisce. Whether you haven't been to the market for a while, have never been to the market, or have been to the market quite a lot, you're going to find a lot in this book to really enjoy.
Thank you, Mary Lou.
Oh, thank
great
you so
information.
Much.
It's not, if it's not already part of your family tradition, you'll want to visit the West Side Market. You can also visit its past and present by just giving a present of Mary Lou's book, Cleveland's West Side Market, 100 Years and Still Cooking. To order it, use the information coming up next. My thanks to Mary Lou for a delicious visit.
To learn more or to order the book, call 1-800-247-6553 or visit www.uakron.edu/UA Press. Next, reconstructing your career.